So children, come to page number 99. Okay, a game of chance. Before you read, have you ever won anything in a lucky dip or other such game of chance? Might be many of you have tried your luck in some sort of fairs. No, there are some options like that where you can just throw the pin or the ball or hit the balloon and you can win something. Do you like such games? I don't think. Personally, if you ask me, I don't like the games because I'm not at all lucky. So I never get anything from this lucky draw. A game of chance. Let's start. Every year on the occasion of Eid, there was a fair in our village. Eid was celebrated only one day, but the fair lasted many days. So what happened? No problem is there related to this festival. The festival is for one day, but the fair will continue for many days. Because it is not only the place for entertainment, it is also the place where many people, they earn their livelihood. Different traders, they just go there to sell their commodities. Tradesmen from far and wide came there with all kinds of goods. Meaning of tradesmen given shopkeepers or people who have goods to sell. So with all kinds of goods to sell. You could buy anything from a small pin to a big buffalo. That means from a small pin, that means something very small, from that to something which is quite big compared to a buffalo. That means the big thing has been compared with this buffalo. Uncle took me to the fair. Bhaiya, who worked for us at home, might be the male domestic help. Okay, came with us. There was a big crowd at the fair. Normally, fair means every time you will find it's such congested. So many people will be there. That means such crowded the places. I personally don't like fairs because of this crowd. Uncle was leading us through the crowd when he met a few of his friends. They wanted him to spend some time with him. So normal, quite normal. If you are having some friends and if your friends, they meet you on your way, definitely they will ask or they will demand that you must pass some quality time with them. Okay. So here also the same thing happened. Uncle asked me whether I would like to go look around the fair with Bhaiya. Till he came back. I was happy to do that because that was some sort of freedom. Uncle is not there, so I will roam around and I will just try to see and buy or eat whatever I want. But there was a problem. What? Uncle warned me neither to buy anything nor to go too far. Far out while he was away. But uncle said, no, you must not buy anything or you must not go too far. It might be quite problematic for you. Okay. I promised that I would wait for him. Bhaiya and I went from shop to shop. There were many things I would have liked to buy. But I waited for uncle to return. A very good child he is. That's why even if the things of the shops, they were quite tempting. They were just calling him that come and buy us. And even he was having some money with him. Still then, he didn't get tempted. And he didn't buy anything. He waited for his uncle's return. That means he is quite an honest child. Good child. Okay. Then we came to what was called the lucky shop. Horrible. The shopkeeper was neither young nor old. He was a middle-aged man. He seemed neither too smart nor too lazy. Just see this child's observation power. At a glance, he had seen all these things of the shopkeeper, that he was not too old nor too young. He was a middle-aged man. He was neither smart nor lazy. So many things he had noticed. He wanted everybody to try their luck. There were discs on the table with numbers from 1 to 10 facing down. All you had to do was to pay 50 paisa, pick up any 6 discs, add up the numbers on the discs and find the total. The article marked with the number was yours. So the articles were present which were having the numbers on them, and the when you are picking up the 6 discs and you are getting the numbers after adding them, after the addition, after the sum, the number which is there stuck on that particular object, that is yours. Okay. An old man paid 50 paisa and selected 6 discs. He added up the numbers on them and found the total was 15. He was given the article marked 15, which was a beautiful clock. But the old man did not want a clock. The shopkeeper obliged him by buying it back for 15 rupees. The old man went away very pleased. So see the matter. The old man, he won the clock. And the worth of that clock was 15 rupees, but he didn't want that clock. And as a result, what happened? The shopkeeper, he was such good at heart, he bought it from him just by paying him 15 rupees. So the old man, he was having a great profit, no? Just by spending 50 paisa, he is getting 15 rupees. That means 14.50, 14 rupees 50 paisa. Is his profit. So everybody will try, will go there to try the luck. And I think this is the loss for the shopkeeper. Let us complete the whole story, then we will understand that whether it was loss for him or profit for him. But at the very, very beginning, whatever we have come to know from this para 5, that it was some sort of loss for the shopkeeper. Then a boy, a little older than I, tried his luck. He got a comb worth 25 paisa. The shopkeeper looked neither happy nor sad. He bought the comb from the boy for 25 paisa. Such a great person he was. The boy tried his luck again. He now got a fountain pen worth 3 rupees. Then he tried a third time and got a wristwatch worth 25 rupees. Then he tried again. He got a table lamp worth more than 10 rupees. So see, the boy was really lucky. The boy was happy and went away with a smile and a good deal of cash. So, such nice thing, no? That means he didn't take all these things along with him. Rather, he took a great deal of cash, or he got a good deal of cash from the shopkeeper. Such a lucky thing for the boy. Okay, children, just give a tick up to this one. And if you are having any query or doubt, you can ask me. Because in the previous class, that means when I was having the class with class 6 Pine, I got the time to teach up to this portion only. So that's why today I cannot go, though we are having time still, I cannot go ahead of it. Because I have taught them up to this portion. Due to traffic, heavy traffic, I was late. So, children, just wait, let me ask you something. Oh, I have already asked, no, that whether you are having problem or not, that's why you have written no problem, no doubt. Okay, just wait then.